this whole ridiculous story, told by one person. Does there anybody here think they can handle it? Fora, and while he's telling it, the rest of you keep whips, red-hot irons in the back of your minds.
Well, sir, my name is Howard Bannister, and I'm from Ames, Iowa.
No excuse.
No, sir, but it all started when I bumped my head in the taxi cab on the way in from the airport.
Are you pleading insanity or amnesia?
Neither, sir, but when I went to the drugstore to get something for a headache, the druggist tried to charge me for a radio because she said her husband would pay for it, but I didn't, of course.
Of course?
Anyway, she ripped my jacket, and when Eunice came along...
Who's Eunice?
Well, Eunice is my fiancé.
You have a wife and a fiancé?
No, sir, but she kept calling me Steve.
Your own fiancé calls you Steve?
No, sir, my wife. Or rather, the one who isn't my wife.
Well, what does the one who isn't your fiancé call you? Howard?
No, sir. The one who isn't my fiancé doesn't call me Howard, and the one who isn't my wife doesn't call me Howard. Because the one who isn't my fiancé is also the one who isn't my wife. The other one who isn't my wife, the one who is my fiancé, she doesn't call me Steve. She calls me Howard. You see?
Let's just skip over this part and move on.
Well, anyway, that night at the banquet, she was there again.
Who was there? Who was there? Your wife or your fiancé?
Neither.
Is a third?
No, sir. The one who isn't either. Everyone was calling her Burnsy.
Why?
Well, that's short for Burns. That's Eunice's last name.
Well, so Eunice was there.
No, sir. Burnsy was there. Or rather, the one who isn't Burnsy.
I think I want to skip over this part, too.
Well, that night I went back to my room and she was there taking a bath.
Who was there? No. Don't tell me. Just go on.
Well, when Eunice walked in and the drapes caught fire and everything burned, they asked me to leave the hotel. I really don't blame them.
Good boy. Is there more?
Oh, sure.
There's more.
Well, the next day, today, Mr. Larrabee asked me to come to his house with my rocks and to bring Eunice, or rather Burnsy, the one he thinks is Eunice. Is that clear?
No, but it's consistent.
Shall I go back over it?
Oh, no, please, I beg you. Just go on.
Well, it gets kind of complicated now. First, there was this trouble between me and you.
You and me?
No, not you. You.
I am you.
You and me?
No, I am you.
Stop saying that. Make him stop saying that.
Don't touch me. I'm a doctor.
Have what?
Music.
Can you fix a hi-fi?
No, sir.
Then shut up.
Well, anyway, he came in and tried to get my case, and then he came in and tried to get his case, and then they came in and tried to get all the cases, and then the shooting started.
They forced me to come with them. I was out in the car the whole time.
You little fake...
You brought up a guy!
Silence! Silence! Order! Now, this is my last warning. I intend to get to the bottom of this web of deceit and confusion if it takes me the rest of my life, which may end at any minute. Blanket. You seem to have caused all this. Exactly what have you got to say for yourself?